Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us quickly see how to enable HTTPS support for AEM instances. Most of the cases, this is the ideal flow for the AEM setup. The first one is for author and the second one is for the live websites. For the authors, browser connects to the load balancer, then load balancer terminate the SSL terminated and connect to the dispatcher slash AEM over HTTP. The communication from the browser to the load balancer is over HTTPS and the communication from load balancer to the backend dispatcher slash AEM is through HTTP. For live websites, browser connects to CDN, then CDN connect to load balancer, the load balancer terminate the SSL terminated and connect to the backend dispatcher slash AEM. Here the communication from browser till this load balancer is over HTTPS. And again, load balancer terminate and the communication from load balancer to the backend dispatcher slash AEM is over HTTP. This would be ideal most of the cases as AEM server will be inside the known network and not exposed externally. SSL termination refers to the process of decrypting the encrypted traffic before sending to the web server. The web server receives the traffic over HTTP. Decrypting the encrypted traffic is a resource-intensive process. The SSL termination at the load balancer helps to reduce the load on web server. In these cases, the SSL certificate should be installed in load balancer for author and in CDN and load balancer for live sites. Different load balancers send different headers to notify the backend systems that SSL is terminated at load balancer. For example, Amazon ELB uses the header X forwarded proto with value HTTPS. The backend server treats the request as HTTPS if this specific header is part of the response. For example, in AEM, if this header is present, AEM matches to the HTTPS node of the ETC map, irrespective of AEM is enabled with HTTPS. Based on the load balancer, the corresponding header should be enabled in AEM through this specific OSA configuration, Apache Felix HTTP service SSL filter. And here we should be specifying the corresponding load balancer header, X forwarded SSL. So if you read here, X forwarded SSL is the general one. Again, Amazon ELB X forwarded proto, what we discussed, even some other header names. So also SSL forward value on. But based on this header, like for Amazon ELB, it is HTTPS. Also, this specific header should be whitelisted in dispatcher. But if required to enable the end-to-end SSL, including AEM, or SSL for individual AEM instances, maybe a local instance, that can be quickly enabled by SSL by default configuration available in AEM. Maybe in our next video, we can see how to configure SSL in dispatcher and enabling the SSL communication between dispatcher and AEM. Let us now see how to enable the SSL for AEM servers through self-signed certificate. Self-signed certificate should be only used for development purpose. Use the CA signed certificate for production systems. As a first step, let us create the self-signed certificate. Ensure the OpenSSL software is enabled in your system. We are going to use OpenSSL for generating the self-signed certificate. Let us create the root certificate key. If you see here gen RSA, then AES256, then output file is rootca.key, then key size 4096. Let me execute this. Yeah, enter a password. Okay, fine now. Let us create a root certificate through the key generated in the previous step. If you see here X509, then specifying the root key, rootca.key, then algorithm, then validity period, then the output file. So here if you see, we are specifying a configuration file, server.csr.cnf. If I go to that file, it has all the basic detail for generating the root certificate, country, state, and all those details. If not, you can specify that in the command prompt, but to simplify that, we can use this configuration file. Even you can skip this root certificate generation and directly generate the SSL certificate. I will let you know towards end of the video what is the use of this root certificate. Let me execute this now. go, password. Fine, now if I go here, the certificate is created. Let us now create a private key and CSR for local certificate. Here again the algorithm, the CSR output file, server.csr, then key size, then key output file, server.key. Again, we are using the same configuration file here. So let me do that. Okay, it's created now. If I go to this, I can see server.csr and server.key. Let us now issue a certificate via the root SSL certificate and the CSR. Here again, X509, the CSR file, server.csr, root certificate, root key, then the output file, server.crt, validity 500 days, algorithm. Here extension file, we are specifying v3.ext. If I go to v3.ext, it has some basic configuration along with the supported domains. It's called subject alternative names, SAN. These all the domains are supported by the self-signed certificate. This includes the local host also. Let me execute this command. So copy this. Okay, password. Okay, it is generated now. If you see, there is a file called server.crt. Server.key was already generated. The self-signed certificate is ready now. We should execute one more command. AM only supports DER format private key. We should convert the server.key, the private key, to DER format. Let us do that. Yeah, here you can see this is the command pkcs8, then output form DER, then the input server key, then output server key. So let me execute this. Okay, now let me go here. Yeah, now it's generated. Let us now enable the AEM configurations. Log into AEM. Click on this notification. Then click on view all. Click on this configure HTTPS task. Then click on open. This will take you to the SSL configuration page. Even you can access directly through this URL. Maybe you can copy this URL and access it. Yeah, this will take you to the same configuration page. Other option is even you can access through this tools, then go to security, you can come to this SSL configuration. Again, it will take you to the same page. Enter a key store password. Let me enter it, password. Then again, confirm that. Then again, store password. Confirm. Okay, click on next. Here select the private key file, so whatever we generated. Okay, server.key.dir, then selected, then certificate file, that is server.crt. So that's fine, click on next. Yeah, here change the domain name, I'm going with the localhost. If you want, you change the port number also. I'm going with the default. Click on done. Yeah, SSL successfully configured. SSL configuration has been successfully completed. Go to HTTPS URL. Yeah, now if you see here, it's taking you to the HTTPS URL, but you are getting a certificate error. Why? Because we use the self-signed certificate. Now let me go to advanced and say proceed to localhost. I will be able to go to the AEM pages through HTTPS and port 8443. If required, the self-signed root certificate can be trusted in your local browsers. For that, we should be executing this specific command in Windows system through PowerShell. So let me copy that. Yeah, set util, add store, then the root certificate, rootca.pem. This is the main reason I created the root certificate, so that we can trust this certificate in our system, so that we will not be seeing the certificate error. So let me copy this, go to this PowerShell. Yeah, I'm just executing this. Now if you see here, completed successfully, it's added into the trusted root certificate. So this root certificate is now trusted in my system. Let me refresh this page. Yeah, still I am getting the certificate error. Let me go to maybe a incognito window. If you see here, now the certificate is trusted. Anyway, let me log in first. Fine, yeah. The certificate is trusted. If I go there, it's saying certificate is valid. So this is only for my browser because I trusted this root certificate, the self-signed certificate. If you see, issued to localhost and issued by localhost again, the validity. If you go to details, you can see all other details, whatever we provided, even the domain supported by this certificate. If you see here, yeah, subject alternative names, localhost is one, but other domains like myexample.com also supported through this specific certificate. This will only work for Edge and the Chrome browsers, mainly the browsers using the Windows certificate store. Yes, we loaded the root certificate into the Windows certificate store. The Firefox has own certificate store. So the root certificate should be loaded separately to the Firefox store. Otherwise, it won't work. Now, if I access the same URL through Firefox, I will be getting the certificate error. I'm skipping that here. Anyway, you can refer to this specific video, Trusted Self-Signed SSL Certificate and Local Domains for Testing. This will give more details on how to manage this Trusted Self-Signed Certificate across different browsers. I will be posting this URL in the video description. Let us now quickly see where the configuration details are stored. So for that, go to Tools, Security, then Users, search for SSL. There is a system user, SSL service. Let me click on this and properties. Yeah, this is account status is active. That's fine. If you go to key store, the actual certificate key, you can find here. If you refer the CRXDE, this is the path for key store, home user, system, security, then SSL service, key store, store.p12. So this is the one. The same way the trust store is over here. Let me select this. etc trust store, then trust store.p12. Let us review the OSA configuration. Let me search with SSL. Yeah, Adobe Granite SSL connector factory. Just to open that. Yeah, here you can see HTTPS port, then 8443, then keystore user, SSL service, then the keystore password we specified, then excluded cipher suites. So even you can modify this. This is the default one. So then included cipher suites. So this one, then you can modify. Then the client certificate. This is mainly for mutual SSL, identifying the client based on SSL certificate. Let us talk more on this in another video. The default value is no client certificate. So means there is no validation based on client certificate. Whatever we enabled so far is server SSL, server certificate, identifying or validating the server through SSL certificate. Even the configuration can be created through HTTP post. This will help us for quick automation. If you see, I am just posting through this post. And this is the URL, Lips Granite Security Post, SSL setup.html. If you see these headers, content type, multi-part, then form data. Then if you go to the body, again, it's select the form data. Then key store password confirm, trust store password. Trust store password confirm, then private key file, select the key file, then certificate file selected, HTTPS port, then 8443, HTTPS host name, we are specifying localhost. You can post through any client, even Java or other programming also to this specific URL. Let me send this. Yeah, it is 200. If I maximize that, if it is success, it will say you. Yeah, this HTTPS has been configured on port 8443. Then the other detail, private key and certificate were stored in the key store of the user SSL service. Also, the same can be executed through curl command. If you see user admin admin, then same variables, key store password, password confirm, then same way trust store password confirm, then the private key file, then the certificate file, HTTP host name and the HTTP port, then the URL, Libs Granite Security Post SSL setup.html. So let me quickly execute this. Yeah, so you see the response, same response, HTTPS has been configured on port 8443, the same thing, private key and certificate key stored. Another configuration option is moving the required configurations between instances through the package. I have already built the package. Maybe let me upload. So upload package. Package was created based on these filters: home users, system, security, SSL service, key store. Then this OSA configuration, app system config, then Granite SSL connector factory.config, and etc trusto. So we can just install this package. In this option, we should perform one more activity: sync the crypto files from source instance to the target instance. For that, identify the bundle ID for this specific bundle, com.adobe.granite.crypto file. Here it is 25. Go to the server location. So if you see here, launchpad, then Felix, then bundle 25. This is the bundle ID we identified. Then the data folder. Here you can see two files, HMAC and master. Copy these two files from source instance to the target instance to the corresponding location. Most of the cases is 25. Also, it's same across the instances. You should also restart the server. Yes, earlier options, the restart is not mandatory, but still you can restart it. In this option, only the changes will reflect after you restart the server. If required, the etc map redirects can be enabled to redirect the traffic from HTTP to HTTPS. Let me quickly show that. So if you see here, etc map HTTP, under that I created a node, localhost.4502. The primary type of this node is /mapping. Then there is a subnode called redirect. Then again, the type of this node is /mapping. Then added this properties /match. This is a wildcard match, any characters. Then /redirect to https://localhost/8443 with the matched one, the pattern matching, the data coming in this pattern and $1. So now if I go to this specific URL, let's say I access http://localhost with 4502, it will redirect me to the HTTPS URL. Because of the wildcard rule, even the path will be considered while redirecting. Let me access this specific URL. So yeah, it's taking me to the target, correct target URL with HTTPS protocol. The AEM instance is now enabled with HTTPS. We have seen how to generate the self-signed certificate along with the root certificate and trusting that root certificate in our browsers. Then using SSL by default configuration option to enable the SSL in AEM. Also, we have seen some alternate options, how we can automate these configurations through HTTP post, curl command or packages. Also, we have seen where these configurations are getting stored, the different configurations. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.